Hey guys, we'll be back again to this, to Always Be Pro. This is our new video. We are going to be learning the JavaScript. You guys, if there's anyone among you who's interested in short course programs, internship, website development, and real programming, I would request you guys, please make sure you come to Always Be Pro IT Digital Solution. It's just found in within Wandegia, in Diamond Trust Banker building. So guys, if anyone interested, please, I'll just see my contact down, or just call me, or send me your email address, then I can forward to you and show you, or send you the location. Above that, then the rest you'll get in our website. Now let me just take it there and we'll see how we can start up with JavaScript programming. Now the first thing I have to let you know with JavaScript is just JavaScript tool. In a simple term, I will simply say it's a programming language which we tend to embed in a given website or even in a system development, if at all it's a web-based application. If you look at so far, JavaScript is the dominant. So for you to become up tomorrow as someone who's very good in React Native or making up iOS web and Android app at the same time, then I think your best idea, have to let you know, not to learn Java. Instead, you should learn one as JavaScript, then take yourself to one as Node.js. From there, you take yourself to one as Express.js. Then you go to React Native, and then later on, learn also one as socket.io. Now, the main thing that I have to talk at the moment is that let us see how we can start up with the JavaScript. Now, to start up with the JavaScript, I'm just going to start up today the main real introduction with the JavaScript on how to start up a JavaScript. The first major thing you don't need to install JavaScript in your machine. The only thing you need is the browser, which I believe you guys, all of you people, you have one on us, Internet Explorer, which is the default version. Though with the Internet Explorer, if you're using Windows 7 and below, or Windows 7 by then below, there's some part of JavaScript that is not enabled. So I advise you, please make sure you have either Chrome installed in your machine. Make sure you have Chrome installed. You either have Chrome or you have one on us Firefox installed in your machine, or you have also Opera Mini. So it's good to have different versions of browser so that you can access your given website, which you will be making, or given a JavaScript application. So let us just now use this minute and learn how to start up giving up JavaScript. Now the first thing I'm going to do, make sure you have an editor. I am going to be using Sublime Text Editor. If you want to download it, please, you just go to browser. I just go to your browser and then you type one on us Sublime here from Google, and just type one on us Sublime Text Editor free download, and then it will give you JavaScript Mini, the Sublime Text Editor. Or you can use your Notepad++, any editor you may be using. If you are from Java environment, then you just use NetBean or Eclipse, will take your stem to the same environment. So let me just start up here. So this is my working folder. I'm just going to create up a new folder inside here, and I'm just going to save this one as one on as index.html, in a simple term. Now to make things simple, I'm just going to generate the HTML syntax, and as soon as I say one on as introduction to JavaScript. Introduction to JavaScript. Now that's just our title to our given page. If you try to refresh here and go to the browser at the moment, I think you can see we have nothing in our page. You have nothing, total nothing. Now to make things simpler, I'm just going to go back in our page here and just echo up a little bit of JavaScript. Now the things is this, in this introduction I want to be so brief and you guys to understand my main point. There are 3 to 4 ways how you can add JavaScript in your page. We are going to learn part one at a go. At the moment, we are going to learn how to add JavaScript in your page. To add JavaScript in your page, we can use one of us the header section. This head section of your page, this is head. Inside the head, you can type put a tag which enables us to run JavaScript, which is called script. Then the type is JavaScript, and that's it. So in between here, this is where we give JavaScript over code or JavaScript code. Now this is method one, how you can add JavaScript into your page. Now method two, if you don't want to add JavaScript in the head section, you can also come inside here and put JavaScript just inside the middle body part of your page. Now this one I'm going to show you with a little bit of shortcut. You can use this type, since we already know we're using HTML5, and HTML5 supports JavaScript, also embedded in this in the JavaScript format, which supports HTML5, which is just you don't need to give the type, just like that's going to be working up for you. Now, if you don't also want to use like that, you can also come down here and also add your JavaScript underneath the HTML. Now, these are the first major things how we can how to add JavaScript. Now, I'm going to also show in the next video, please. We are going to learn today, next video, how do you tend to add JavaScript in an external file. Now, what you have learned today is what known as adding JavaScript in internal file within the HTML element. So, this is how we add the syntax of a given JavaScript program. So, guys, thanks you for watching. Please make sure you subscribe to OSP Pro. And if there's anything you have as a complaint or as a comment, please make sure you comment down. I'll let you guys updated. And if there's anything that you'd like us to share with me, please make sure we share. And if you have other new things, please make sure you tune on and make sure you subscribe.